हाय फ्रेंड्स, कैसे हैं आप? आशा है आप बिल्कुल ठीक हैं। फ्रेंड्स, ट्रोमेटिक रेटिकुलो पेरिटोनाइटिस या पेरिकार्डाइटिस, जिसको हार्डवेयर डिजीज भी कहते हैं, इट्स कॉमन इन कैटल एंड बफलो एंड इट कॉजेज ए लॉट ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स एंड मेनी अ टाइम्स द एनिमल डाइज बिकॉज ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम, राइट? सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस समथिंग अबाउट ट्रोमेटिक रेटिकुलो पेरिटोनाइटिस, कॉमनली नोन एज द TRP. And I will show you some pics and some video clips of animals affected with TRP. Right? Friends, I am Professor Govind Narayan Purohit, the former head veterinary gynecology and the former dean postgraduate studies, Rajuwas, Bikaner. So friends, TRP or the hardware disease is the most common cause of anterior abdominal pain in cattle. The ingestive behavior of cattle predisposes them to accidental swallowing of metallic foreign objects that settle in the reticulum. The cattle and buffalo neither use their lips for prehension nor they completely masticate the food. Hence, they are more likely to ingest foreign bodies including metallic objects, nails, needles, wires, and these animals are more likely to ingest plastic also. But this the metallic foreign objects are going to cause a lot of problems to cattle and buffalo. See friends, when the animal just swallows the fodder, along with that fodder some pieces of nails or maybe some wire or needles or something, any metallic object, it swallows and it uses the rotatory movement of the tongue to just push the feed inside, and the metallic objects, they fall into the reticulum. In the reticulum there are contractions, and these contractions lead to piercing. The reticulum has a honeycomb structure, you can see in this picture, and when there are contractions, these metallic objects may just pierce the reticulum. Sometimes they may cause peritonitis. At other times, you can see in this picture, reticulum is just near to the heart, so they may pierce the reticulum and then enter into the pericardial sac, causing pericarditis. At other times, the metallic objects, they can enter into the liver, causing liver abscess, or the spleen, which are just nearby the reticulum. And so this causes a lot of problems to the animal. The clinical findings, early clinical findings, could be recurrent tympany, scanty feces, arched back, and the stretched abdomen. The animal, when the metallic objects are in the rumen, are in the reticulum, they may cause a lot of problems to the animal, and animal may have grunt, may grunt frequently because of the pain, and then the animal has an anxious look, and it stands with an arched back, and the it will become off feed, the milk yield will go down, and the animal may face recurrent tympany. During the postpartum period, these types of nails are more likely to cause a lot of problem, and the animal, because of the pressure of the fetus and the contractions of the reticulum, the foreign bodies may go to different places. The most common place is the heart. When the foreign body just enters into the pericardial sac, then the animal will have brisket edema. It's very common to have to show a huge brisket edema. Then the animal will have gaping respiration, difficulty in walking, standing and sitting, and you can see in this picture the buffalo is having very difficulty in respiration, and here there is a brisket edema which pits on pressure. Now, I show you a small clip of a buffalo suffering from the traumatic pericarditis. You can see here, there is a huge brisket edema. The animal is off feed and it is having a arched back, this buffalo, and the buffalo is having decrease in the milk yield, rumination has been decreased, and you can see here, this is the edema on the brisket, and when we apply pressure on the brisket, it fits on pressure. So brisket edema, and sometimes the edema extending up to the jaw would be found in animals which are now suffering from traumatic pericarditis, and the animal will have difficulty in breathing also because of the pericarditis or because of the then animal may show signs of peritonitis earlier, and sometimes the signs may go away and then again appear at a later time. You can see this buffalo, it's having a difficulty, a difficult respiration, open mouth respiration, and again this buffalo is also having edema on the brisket. So these are some of the findings of the animals that suffer from traumatic pericarditis. Then animals with traumatic pericarditis may also have a prominent jugular vein, or what you call the jugular stasis, and then we press it with a finger, then again the jugular is raised immediately. And this cow, it's also having a huge brisket edema, and the jugular vein has become very prominent, and when we press it, then the vein again raises spontaneously, and this remains raised and a prominent jugular vein. Then the diagnosis is based on the blood picture with a neutrophilia shift to left. This is the most common procedure that is used for early diagnosis of the condition. Then increased total protein and fibrinogen are also some supportive diagnostic methods. Then pinching of the withers of the animal leads to intense pain in the animal, and then there is a pole test wherein a bamboo is placed just underneath the chest and it is raised, and animal shows a sharp grunting or sharp pain, and then radiography, if it is possible. At many places it is not possible, but at places where it is possible, radiography can throw some light. You can see here a displaced reticulum with the foreign bodies, metallic foreign bodies, shown in this radiograph of a buffalo, a lateral radiograph. Then ultrasonography can help in diagnosis of pericarditis, and this is the bamboo test or the pole test applied on a buffalo, wherein it is placed on the chest and it is raised, so animal feels intense pain. So rarely, or the foreign body may pierce through the reticulum, cause peritonitis, and then it may cause an abscess over the skin near the elbow, and this abscess may then rupture to release plenty of pus, and sometimes the foreign body may also come out. This is a ultrasound picture of a heart showing thickening of the pericardial sac and then presence of pus inside the pericardial sac. Now the therapy, medical therapy, is usually less helpful and depends on the location of the metallic foreign body and the extent of damage it has caused. Sometimes the foreign body will remain in the reticulum, or it may pierce the reticulum causing peritonitis. Sometimes it may enter into the rumen, and most of the times it enters into the pericardial sac or the liver or the spleen, and symptoms of peritonitis might be present. Animal may develop fever, and after some time the animal may recover although the foreign body remains there only, or it may have moved to another place. Antibiotics and peritoneal lavage offer only temporary relief, and oral administration of magnets have been tried in many reports, but they might not always be successful. These magnets are passed into the reticulum, and they will just stick all the foreign nails or pieces of wire or something like that. But 24 to 48 hours of administration of an oral Rumen magnet, this should be evaluated, and if it has not reached the Rumen, then the prognosis, and sometimes pieces which have pierced the reticulum will not attach to the magnet. Then Rumenotomy is suggested in some cases, but it is not always promising. One can just perform Rumenotomy to remove some of the foreign bodies, but not essentially the metallic foreign bodies, just piercing the reticulum. Therapy of traumatic pericarditis is nearly hopeless. Thoracotomy and pericardiotomy are difficult to perform, and many approaches have been suggested, but the results are not potentially useful. So friends, kindly share and subscribe to my channel Govind Narayan Purohit. This is my YouTube handle @ Professor Govind Narayan Purohit. Kindly give your comments, give your likes, give your suggestions, and kindly share my video and subscribe to my channel Govind Narayan Purohit. Thank you. Bye-bye.